Hello world! Today, I would like to talk about the graphics on Zeal 8-bit computer. Last time I talked about it was in my first video, posted a few months ago. So let's get right into it. If you follow my videos, you should know that I'm relying on an FPGA for the graphics. And several reasons led me to make this choice. First of all, graphic chips are not made anymore, and finding an FPGA in brand new condition is not a hard task today. Secondly, this led me to fully control how graphics are rendered, and finally, I can decide for the memory organization, the screen resolution, sprites, well, all the capabilities basically. Here is what my FPGA implementation is currently capable of. I'm using a custom FPGA board I made myself, which relies on the Altera EP4CE10. The video RAM is implemented using FPGA's internal RAM, or VRAM. It lets me output a VGA signal with a resolution of 640 by 480. Two modes are supported, text and graphics. In text mode, we can display up to 80 characters per line and 40 characters per column, for a total of 3200 characters. In text mode, we have up to 16 colors, which can be chosen for both background and foreground. In graphic mode, we can display up to 40 tiles per line, 30 tiles per column, so a total of 1200 tiles. Currently, up to 128 different tiles can be displayed on screen at the same time. This means that in order to fill the entire screen, some tiles need to be repeated. Each pixel of the 16 by 16 tiles can have 256 different colors taken from the 8-bit VGA palette. I would like to precise that I'm talking about tiles and not sprites. Thanks to some comments I received in the first video, I got more details about the real denomination of these graphics items. Let's see how they both work. This is our 640 by 480 screen. We get tiles by splitting the screen into multiple smaller squares. I decided to use 16 by 16 pixels squares, which gives us this 40 by 30 grid. Representing tiles in a video memory or VRAM is fairly simple. We can see them as a one-dimension array of 8-bit values. So the size of this array is 1200 bytes. Let's call it the tilemap array. The first element of the array is the first one of the grid. The second one of the array is also the second one on the grid, same for the third one, etc., etc., until 1199. Each of the cells contain an 8-bit value. In my case, this value is between 0 and 127. So it could be 42, 127, 34, 65, well, you see. Let's flip the figure and remove the color to understand better. Now the question is, what does the number inside each tile represent? It represents the index of another array containing the real pixels. We will call that one the tileset array. If you're familiar with C or C++, you can see these values as pointers. Let's see how this tileset array is organized. Each tile is 16 by 16 pixels, and each pixel can be one of any color from the 8-bit VGA palette, so a maximum of 256 values. For example, a value of 0 represents the first color of the palette, which is black, a value of 1 represents the second one, which is the dark blue, 2 represents the dark green, and it goes for any color in the palette. Therefore, we can virtually split our tileset array into 256 byte blocks, and we get this. At index 0, we have a 16 by 16 pixels image. At index 1, we get another one, same for index 2, same for 3, until 127. So in total, we get 128 images. And the fact is, this maximum value of 127 is only limited by the amount of video RAM we have. Let's take an example to understand better. Let's try to render this palm tree. As you can see, it's a 16 by 16 pixel image, which is already using the VGA palette colors. We start by representing each pixel by its index in the VGA palette, or its number. So the first pixel becomes 67. The second one is 66, the third one is also 66, and we fill it for each pixel of the image, and we get this grid. 256 8-bit values. And so now, in our tileset array, we can store these bytes at index 1. The palm tree becomes the second image, because remember, the tileset array is organized as 256 bytes block. Now back to the tilemap array. Here, we will decide where to show the palm tree on screen. To do so, we only need to place the value 1, which is the palm tree image index, in any cell of the grid. It can be in multiple cells at the same time. To place it in the top left corner, we need to write 1 in the first cell of the tilemap array. If we want to place it on the second line, we need to write 1 in the cell of index 39. And this is it for the tiles. But now the question is, how to move these objects smoothly? For a tree, it doesn't really make sense, but what about game character? Like this one. We can move it from tile to tile, but it means that the granularity is 16 pixels. We cannot move the graphical object less than 16 pixels away. This is where sprites come in. A sprite is very similar to a tile. The difference relies in its tilemap array equivalent that we will call sprites attributes array. In this array, we have n entries, where n is the number of maximum sprites. Usually, the number of sprites on screen is much smaller than the number of tiles. In each entry, we have some attributes. Position x for the x position on screen, position y for the y position on screen, image index, the set of pixels from the tile set array to show at the given position, and flags, which usually define if the sprite is enabled, disabled, if there is transparency, mirror, rotation, any transformation. So now we can place our objects anywhere on the screen. The positions in X and Y don't need to be a multiple of 16. Here is what we can do with the character now. It's moving much more smoothly than before. To sum up, tiles are used for background and anything that is static. Sprites, on the other hand, are used for foregrounds and animated objects. Let's see the future improvements now. Currently, my FPGA video chip implementation does not have any sprite yet, but this is something I really want to implement in the near future. Another interesting feature I would like to add is the possibility to replace the color palette on the fly. In fact, the FPGA can output 16-bit colors, so it would be nice to replace the hard-coded VGA palette by any palette at runtime defined by the user. It would also be very nice if we had more resolutions. And also, it would be nice to have more color modes, like 2-bit black and white or 4-bit colors. And finally, a bitmap mode for lower resolutions where we would be able to render pixel by pixel. Currently, I'm also working on another PCB for the FPGA board in order to switch from the Altera one to a Lattice one. This will not only give me more internal RAM, but it's also much simpler to find and to buy. I didn't talk about the text mode because I talked about it and demonstrated it in a previous video I made named How to Write a Hello World on Zeal 8-bit Computer. You can check that video if you want more details about it. So this is it for the first part of the graphics on Zeal 8-bit Computer. I would like to particularly thank Sprite TM for his help on this project. If you like retro things and embedded projects, anything related to this, you can take a few minutes to check his website. I will put a link in the description. In the next part, we will see how to actually write a Z80 program that displays tiles on a screen. So that's it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed it, and see you next time.